need to stretch a hallway and a room. So the room, just gonna stretch it from the bed over. Here, I think the wrinkle goes the whole direction. And in the hall, I'm gonna cut it at the end over there. Stretch it and seam it together. Cut out about an inch or so. And there's also a patch on the stairs that I'll show shortly. Okay, I've taken out the carpet on the stairs here. And all around the way to there. And now I'm going to stretch it together and cut out about an inch. Alright, the hall's been stretched out. And I have cut this much out of the carpet, holding it together with stay nails. And getting ready to seam it together. And the carpet's greater than 10 years old, so got extra tape put under it. I'm getting ready to melt it all together. I'll check in shortly. Okay, this is step one of melting this all together here. It'll be a little bit putting all this together because it's very old and I'm afraid it may try to fall apart, so we've got extra tape underneath it. So I've got to seam it a little wider on both sides. I'll show a little more shortly. Now I've switched the irons around a couple different times here, going wider with it to get the perpendicular tape that reaches out and grabs it and holds it a little better. And I've still got to do that over here. Alright, it's all seamed in. I'm going to let the stay nails hold it for at least 10-15 more minutes so it all cools off and in place. And being that it's worn like it is, I put more tape on it and can hide the seam a little better when it's worn like that, because the steam rejuvenates the fibers, makes them stand up again. So you can get a better concealment on your seam when you're putting together extremely worn carpet. It's about 10 or 12 years old. Now, if you lift, there's a little piece here that needs to be patched in because the carpet, when it's stretched, it went over that much. So now that much is missing here. So I'm gonna probably patch a little piece of this in there. I'll show that next. Alright, I cut a little piece and I fit it in there. And now I'm melting that in place. And then I'll show that when I get finished. I'll probably show the backside, just exactly what I did whenever it cools off. Over here sometimes when you're pulling up carpet, you'll find a place where it broke loose, or it either got old or sometimes it didn't adhere well. Put this back together here in a minute too. I'll show that when I'm done. This is seamed in there now, and it's cooling, so I will pull that back and show that in a minute as soon as I know it's cool. I have it here, and I'm putting this piece back together that had come apart. Okay, this is the end result here. This is where I seamed it from the top, cut it to fit, and this is what I cut off the other side and trimmed all this to fit. All of this goes back in there and tucks in under the Z-bar there. I'll show when I get all finished up. And I'm gonna go, oh, and there's this piece here that I seamed back together. I'll go down the stairs and patch a piece in down the way. Alright, there is damaged place from, I guess, the dog on the stairs. So I'm gonna try to take a piece of carpet that I took out of the hall upstairs and patch it in there. So let's see how that works. Okay, now what's going on is I've cut a piece out. I'm going to patch a piece in. When I get done, I'm going to show this and you can comment as to how you think I did it. Probably be cleaning next week. It's all patched in now. Only attrition was the steam got a little bit of the board is made of wood. Sometimes they're made of paper, sometimes they're made of wood. This one's paper. So as soon as that dries out, it'll go back down. Our hair dryer will speed it up. At any rate, unless you know where to look, you won't be able to tell this is here, and I'll conceal it more when it's clean. Alright, one room of stretching left. The hall is done. I'll put back around the stairs. Still see this a little bit where the wrinkle was. That will go away when I clean it. And here, I'm going to stretch this wrinkle out now. So I'll show that. I'm stretching. It takes a few times to pull it all and make it relax. So, be a little bit longer. Pulled it twice so far, at least two or three more times. Alright, it's all stretched in now, and that's how much carpet got stretched. So I'm going to trim that off and show the finished product, and that will finish up this particular carpet job. Okay, all done here. The stretching, and that's the amount that was stretched off, probably inch and a half, whatever. That's where the wrinkle was, and that hides completely when I clean. And I'll go over my carpet tools here in another short video clip. Anyway, Corey Thibodeau with CarpetMuscle.com in Austin, Texas, 512-350-1129. Call or text with questions. Always happy to help.